Today I wanted to show you guys my current favorite full coverage drugstore foundation routine. I end up mixing a lot of foundations at the drugstore, so I do experiment a lot with different foundation formulations and how they work with each other. And recently I found a combination that works like magic. I put it on, it's full coverage, it's sweat proof, it lasts throughout the day, and it looks flawless upon application. So that combination is the Covergirl Vitalist Healthy Elixir with the Dermacol Makeup Cover. Now in the Covergirl Vitalist, I am in the shade Buff Beige, and then in Dermacol, I am in the shade 110. Now I find that when I mix these two together, I end up with a full coverage look, but one that looks like skin still. It lasts throughout my commute to work, which is walking about a mile, and by the time I get to work, it still looks flawless. And the shade match, it actually works out near perfect for my skin and undertone. Now, I do still call this drugstore since both are under the $20 mark when it comes to foundation. That's kind of my dollar limit. Anything under 20, I consider drugstore. Anything over 20, I'll go ahead and consider higher end. The Dermacol, I was able to get on Amazon for about $12. And the CoverGirl Vitalist, I got at CVS for about $13. So you are paying over 20 for the two of them together, but you are getting, you know, 2 full ounces of product since you are mixing them together. I do have Amazon Prime, so the shipping on the Dermacol was free. The only downside was that it was a little bit harder to shade match the Dermacol. I ended up buying about 3 shades and only one of them ended up working out, but it was a very close shade match. So that's my only downside, is that you will kind of have to guess when it comes to your Dermacol shade. I did look up swatches, I looked up videos, and they're just not the most accurate. I mean, the best way to shade match, unfortunately, is to actually look at the product, get it out of the bottle, try it on your face, and thankfully I was able to find a shade that worked for me. So if you're kind of like my skin tone, I'm a lighter, very yellow undertoned skin tone. I was lucky in the shade 110. I originally tried shade 118 and that did not work. It was pure orange. So I would stay away from shade 118 from the Dermacol line and start out a little lower. That's my advice. So if you are going to try Dermacol, go a little lighter than you think you're going to be based on the swatches, because the swatches I see tend to go just a little dark. So if you'd like to see how these two foundations combine and apply, you're in the right spot. Just keep watching. To prime today, I'm going to be using my usual method, which is a bottom layer of the Benefit Porefessional, and then topping that off with the Photo Finish Primer Water from Smashbox. This is the amount of the Dermacol that I will use, a really tiny, tiny amount, and I will mix it with a full pump from the CoverGirl Vitalist, and that's what a full pump looks like. Mixed together, this is the shade that comes out. It is a very good shade match for me, and I just dot this on and I blend it out with a brush. Now I have tried blending this combination out with a sponge, and I believe the coverage and application just looks a lot better with the brush. The finish with the sponge looks nice though, so for a couple of areas I will go on top and finish it out with the sponge. This is what my face looks like after just one layer of that combination. As you can see, the forehead looks pretty perfect. I do have some breakouts on the middle of my forehead that I was able to cover. I don't normally spot conceal after using this. It does cover up everything that I really needed to cover up. Please ignore my eyebrows, they do need to get done. Thanks to the power of editing, the rest of my makeup is now on, and to set everything, I will be using the new Morphe Prep and Set Setting Spray. I am very much enjoying the spray and the fact that it is an aerosol can. So I will apply a healthy dose of the setting spray just to set everything. And I'm sorry that this is out of focus. I actually filmed an entire, like, get ready with me on the rest of the look, but it was, the whole video was incredibly out of focus, so I actually had to scrap it. I only used this part so I could show you guys how I set the rest of the foundation. And this is the finished look. Now, I found that this look does last me throughout the day. It doesn't break down on me when I get sweaty in my T-zone. It lasts throughout a 1.5 mile walk to and from work and throughout my work day. So this has been my go-to look. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope I see you in my next video. Bye.